Here are 11 new shortcuts you've never seen before. From hacking the Apple Notes widget to show you a daily quote, generate a daily health report from your data in Apple Health, quickly resize images from the share sheet, shorten URLs for free, create things tasks from bare notes, and a ton more. And most of these came from requests by you in the YouTube comments and in my shortcuts community. Let's get into it. First, if you're new to shortcuts, don't sleep on the gallery tab. And even if you've not been here in a while, kudos to the shortcuts team because there's been some new shortcuts added that I haven't seen before, and some of them are really powerful. This first one's just for fun. If you wanted to create a meme that's text over an animated GIF, you can do that with a shortcut. I'll just choose a GIF here, add a little text, I can choose where I want to put it, and shortcuts is actually going to just make that meme for me in a second. Number two, this request came from Graham here in the YouTube comments. He wanted an updated morning routine that not only shows you your calendar events and reminders, but also pulled the latest news headlines. Now, the news part is a bit of a challenge. If you're wanting the top news from a specific source, I chose to pull it via RSS feed, and the New York Times homepage is what I have here, but you can change this RSS feed for anything. CNN has a breaking news feed, and he wanted to use Apple News, but unfortunately the only Apple News actions will open the Today feed or show topics, but there's no top news or biggest stories kinds of action. Now, if you have another source where you'd want to pull news from, let me know down in the comments. I can build it around that. But when you run this shortcut, it puts together all the information for the day, like it gives you the weather, events for today, reminders, and it has the top news stories here with the links. Now, you can create an Apple Note so those links are clickable with this information. And you can have the shortcut read this out to you so you can run it from a HomePod. I would probably add a ChatGPT action to summarize the top stories and just tell me them in a few sentences. And if you're wanting a shortcut like that, let me know down in the comments. Once Apple Intelligence comes out this fall, that's going to become much easier. Number three, Steven in the community wanted a quote of the day, like an inspirational quote, but that shows up in a widget automatically. And you can actually hack Apple Notes to do exactly this. First of all, you have to have a source. So I'm using this website, inspiringquotes.com. There's a new quote every day, and that seemed like a pretty consistent source. Again, let me know if there's a different source you'd want to use in the comments of this video, and I can build that. It makes HTML out of that webpage, pulls the quote and the author through a match text action, and then adds this to Apple Notes, and it puts it in a folder called quotes. Create that folder first in Apple Notes if you don't have it. Now, when I run this, it happens that quickly. You can program this in an automation to run every morning. And because it's a dedicated folder in Apple Notes, you can add a widget to your home screen that shows that folder called quotes. And then you can actually wake up to a new quote in that widget every day. This is just using Apple Notes and shortcuts. It's all built in, totally free, and you have inspirational quotes every day. Now, you can also use this method of an Apple Notes folder and a widget if there's other information you want to see every day, just in a widget automatically. If you have ideas for that, let me know. Number four, Steve from the community wanted to be able to pull a health report from his Apple Health data and have it either in a note or just save it every day. Now, here in Shortcuts, there's an action for find all health samples, and you can choose a variety of data that's in Apple Health. Now, obviously choose data that you're actually tracking, what your Apple Watch tracks, or if you're taking your blood pressure in Apple Health. But then you can run this every day, and it's gonna pull a summary. My resting heart rate's a little high because I just woke up and started making videos. Also why there's not a lot of steps. But you can choose whatever data from those actions, add it to different variables, and then put it together in a text block. I just have a few pieces of data here, and you'll see at the bottom of the shortcut this text block where you can add just a little text and then the data that you're pulling. But now you can create a health report, save this to Apple Notes or somewhere else, and have a record of this information. And it also averages things like resting heart rate, blood oxygen, and things like that. Number five, if you make task lists in Apple Note, but you want to move those to reminders, this shortcut does exactly that. When you run this shortcut, you can choose from your Apple Notes. I have a note here with YouTube tasks, which has a to-do list, and I'll show you how to format that in Apple Notes, but then it creates those tasks in reminders automatically. So it ran in the background, and these are the two tasks in my note. Make great videos, and then do that again. Now, from the Apple Note, you want to make sure you're actually using a to-do list. To do that, that's using this symbol right here, which creates a checklist, and then the shortcut will interpret any of these checklist items and create reminders for them. Also, shout out to Bexyboo in the shortcuts community because they've been helping people build their shortcuts, which, by the way, if you love these shortcuts videos and want to learn more about it, you can join my shortcuts community. Over 1,700 people have joined for free. And over 450 people have become a paying member for $5 a month or $50 a year, and you get access to my shortcut of the week where I don't share in videos, my custom-trained shortcuts GPT, which I've recently trained on make.com to help with some shortcuts requests, and you can search my entire shortcuts database. That's a little confusing, so if you become a member, here's how you can search it. Just tap the search box here in circle, search for anything like home ETA, what might be a shortcuts title, and then here in the search results on circle, click space, And then you can just check Shortcuts Database. That's where I've put all the shortcuts I've built across all 50 plus of my Shortcuts videos. And here you can jump to a specific shortcut, download it right here. And you can do that when you become a member. To do that, join at create.beard.fm, and you're supporting the channel when you do. And thank you so much to the hundreds of people who have already joined and became a member. Number 6, if you want to resize images directly from the share sheet, you can do that. This is a simple shortcut. When you're looking at an image and you hit the share button, this is going to resize it. You can change this number 300 to whatever pixel size you would like. And then it's going to copy that image to your clipboard if you want to paste it somewhere. You can also save it to your camera roll and add that action if you'd like. But now if I'm looking at an image, I can tap share. There's my resized 300 pixels and paste. So now that image is resized, it's on my clipboard right now. And now I can just paste that image, and it's that smaller size that I set in the shortcut. Number 7, this was another shortcut I found in the gallery recently, and it simply gives you an image of the day from NASA. Then you can save it, maybe use it as a wallpaper, but I'm always looking for automated wallpaper type things, and you can combine this with the set wallpaper action and wake up to a new wallpaper every day. Number 8, another gallery find was using this URL shortener, .gd, which I think is like is good, but you can shorten any URL from the share sheet and copy it to your clipboard. So let's say I want to share this URL, I can just hit the share button, tap Shorten URL, and it's going to copy it to my clipboard automatically, but I also put a quick look action so you can see what it looks like. And there's the short URL to this web page. Pretty slick. Number 9, this was another request from the community, but they wanted a choose from menu option that would allow them to open a folder in the Files app. So what this shortcut has is a choose from menu at the top. I have 4 options here, but you can add more. And then under each folder action, you would actually use the Files action in shortcuts. It's a little counterintuitive, but then you can choose a folder. I'll just choose the downloads folder on my iPhone. And now when I choose menu option 1, it'll open that folder in the Files app. Go through and choose your specific folders in each of those actions. And now when you run the shortcut, and I would also change the names of the folders, but you can tap it and then open that folder directly on your iPhone. Robert from the community wanted a shortcut because he takes notes in Bear, which I do too, where it will take the title of the Bear note and create a to-do in the Things app. So that's exactly what this shortcut does. When you run it, choose one of your recent Bear notes, and it will take the title of that note and create a to-do in Things. If I go to the Things app and the inbox, that was the title of my note, and it adds a link to the Bear note here in the notes section of the Things task, so I can jump right to that Bear note. All right, and for number 11, I'm gonna sneak in one Apple Intelligence shortcut. I keep playing around with the Transcribe and Use Model actions, and I built this for my Mac, but it actually runs anywhere you have either iOS 26 and Apple Intelligence, or your Mac with Apple Intelligence. But here, you can transcribe any audio file. This can live in the share sheet as an action. It uses the built-in Transcribe action, uses the Use Models action to give you a summary, and this is way more consistent than the actual ChatGPT action. So while it says ChatGPT, you'll see this is actually the Apple Intelligence Models action. Figures out a title for the note, again, using ChatGPT, does a bunch of things to make the formatting. You can choose whether you want the transcript only, transcript with a summary, and then finally creates a note with all that information. This was actually a request, and they wanted a bunch of options like this to choose what parts of the summary or transcript they add to the note, but I'll link to this shortcut in the video description below along with all the other shortcuts. Just know you have to be on the beta to run this, but pretty soon you won't have, but pretty soon this is going to be out for everyone. So get subscribed and hit that like button, because once iOS 26 comes out publicly for everyone, there's going to be a lot of videos on Apple Intelligence shortcuts, plus features in iOS 26, macOS Tahoe, and more. Now, if you missed my video on 100 plus iOS 26 features, you can check it out right up here. And if you want to see my Apple Intelligence specific shortcuts that I built early on in the process and you can download right now, check out my video on those right up here. Remember, you can join my community at create.beard.fm. Appreciate your support there. And of course, thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.